The Philippine Tourism Department sees no need to reimpose strict travel restrictions despite an uptick in COVID cases. Tourism Chief Cristina Garcia Frasco cites the declaration of the World Health Organization that COVID is no longer a global health emergency. Frasco says the Philippines should focus on opening up its travel and tourism industry instead.
While we continue to support the Department of Health's measures as far as ensuring the health and safety of our fellow Filipinos, the direction of the Philippines is forward, and that is to ensure that we continue to open up the country to travel and tourism, as is the direction set by our president. Of course, all the minimum health and safety standards are in place, and this is also made sure of as far as compliance with our DOT-accredited establishments.
The remark comes following President Marcos's approval of the National Tourism Development Plan for 2023 until 2028. Secretary Frasco says it seeks to make the Philippines a tourism powerhouse. So far, the number of international arrivals in the country this year is already at 2 million, higher than 2022's 1.7 million. Baguio City reimposing the use of face masks in indoor settings. That's amid the rising number of COVID-19 cases in the country. Baguio Mayor Benjamin Magalong said the city is logging an average of 13 to 14 COVID cases a day. Aside from wearing face masks, he also urged everyone to complete their vaccination against the disease and to avoid handshakes for now. The Philippines posted 2,109 new COVID-19 cases Sunday. The City of Manila also reinstating the mandatory wearing of face masks at City Hall. Mayor Honey Lacuna said workers and guests should mask up to prevent the spread of COVID-19. She clarifies the policy only covers the Manila City Hall and its satellite offices, and not the whole city. As of Monday, Manila has 217 active COVID cases. Despite an uptick in COVID cases, an infectious diseases expert calls the Okta Research Group's positivity rate reports alarmist. Dr. Edsel Salvania said the positivity rate is no longer a good measure to determine the status of COVID-19 in the country. He says the public should instead look at the healthcare utilization rate and the number of severe cases. Okta Research Group has said Metro Manila's positivity rate as of May 13 has climbed to 25.4%.
I don't understand why people are still talking about positivity rate. We've been living with the rules, with the mandates for the last 3 years, and I think we've already learned how to manage this. So we're shifting the burden of protection from the government to the individual. And I think after 3 years, if you've gotten vaccinated, you know when to wear a mask, especially in crowded conditions. If you're at risk, you can increase your protection. I think we're okay. Yung itong mga naririnig natin ng mga positivity rates and everything, that's noise. It's not scientific.
Over now to Kuwait's sweeping entry ban on Filipinos. A lawmaker proposes several measures that would help ensure the welfare of Filipino workers in the Gulf state. The chairman of the House Panel on Overseas Workers Affairs says shelters for abused workers should be a non-negotiable during the talks between Philippine and Kuwaiti officials. Cabayan Representative Ron Salo also proposes so-called proof-of-life measures to protect Filipinos in Kuwait.
One of those, perhaps, is requirement by the employer that they would bring the Filipino worker to the Foreign Recruitment Agency's office or at the Polo's office regularly, perhaps once every quarter, or perhaps even a month, every month. Uh-oh. This is what we call the proof of life, to make sure that we, even there are no police officers going into the homes of the employers, we're pretty assured that our Filipino workers are really being treated well. There are certain employers who still hold the passport of the household worker. And when in fact the bilateral agreement clearly states that this particular passport is a document of the Philippine government and should not be held by the employer. Perhaps one of the things that I'm seeing there is it could be held by the Philippine Embassy or the Polo.
Kuwait has banned the entry of Filipinos without residency permits, claiming the Philippines violated their labor agreement. It remains unclear, even to Philippine officials, what that violation is. The Sugar Regulatory Administration assures the public there will be no more anomaly in the next batch of sugar imports. This after President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. approved the additional importation of up to 150,000 metric tons of sugar. SRA Acting Administrator Pablo Azcona says the importation will be above board and open to all registered traders. The past two sugar importations under the Marcos administration were hounded by controversies. The first one was called illegal by the palace, while the other one has been dubbed a large-scale agricultural smuggling. The Philippine Agriculture Department insists the country still has enough supply of onions, but it admits the stock for red onions may only last until November, while the supply of white onions may be depleted September. The agency says the country should start prioritizing off-season planting.
Kung ngayon ang pinag-uusapan, sapat ang stock natin. Kasi kaani nga lang eh. So usually ang stock natin dyan tumatagal ng ilang buwan. Yun ang paganda natin pagka kapusin tayo. Ang hindi kasi natin nagagawa yung off-season planting eh. Kaya yung mga off-season planting, dapat yun ang mga pagigihin natin para meron pa rin tayong supply sa mga darating na buwan. Otherwise, mapipilitan na naman tayo mag-import.
The Agriculture Department also refutes claims of overpricing in its push for the use of biofertilizers.
Hindi overpriced kasi wala pa naman pinipilit at hindi naman sinasabi yung presyo na yun talaga ang gagamitin eh. Example lang yung nakita nila, computation ng cost effectiveness.
A Philippine senator wants to bring back the death penalty for police officials involved in the illegal drug trade. Senator Bong Revilla floated that possibility as the Senate panel on public order and dangerous drugs resumes its probe on the alleged cover-up in a 6.7 billion peso drug haul last year. His proposal was supported by former Philippine police chief and now Senator Ronald De La Rosa.
Kailangan na ba na ibalik ang bitay para mapatino natin ang mga ito? When the people ought to enforce the law are the very ones who break it, shouldn't the gavel fall hardest on them? Kaya lumalakas ang loob ng mga maliliit na kriminal at iba pang masasamang loob ay dahil sa mga kagaya nitong mga sangkot na pulis na ito, na sa kabila ng labis na kabulukan, ay patuloy pa rin nakakatakas sa pangil ng batas.
The National Police Commission, meanwhile, refused to name the four high-ranking police officers who were linked to the drug trade after a sweeping review. The NAPOCOM says it is still building up cases against them. Senator Francis Escudero warns against the reacquisition of government stake in the National Grid Corporation of the Philippines. He says it can be destabilizing and expensive. Escudero also doubts government's capability to run the NGCP, saying the state's failure in the past led to the privatization of the agency. At least four senators have called for a review of the NGCP franchise, which is 40% owned by Chinese investors. Senator J.V. Ejercito asserts government should have full control of public utilities.
Kung wala sana tayong dispute sa kasulukuyan sa China, with Philippine Tea, pansin nyo lately, medyo aggressive, medyo hostile na itong mga Chinese Coast Guard at Chinese government sa pakikitungo sa atin. Kaya hindi mo maalis sa akin pangamba na pwede tayong makarelease sa isang pagpindot lang ba kaya ako po yung mga utilities tulad ng National Grid Corporation, ng airport na management system, dapat po yan manatili sa ating pong control lalo na sa Pilipinong korporasyon o entity.